Einstein was around. We saw him most days. He would come in. He would walk in sometimes with Gödel. But they looked like Mutt and Jeff, tall Einstein and little tiny Gödel. They were deep in conversation about something or other. I don't know what. I never spoke with Einstein except to say hello and good morning or something, and I suppose he would answer Guten Morning or whatever.
He was not involved or interested, I should say, with, I know he wasn't involved, he showed no great interest in sort of what was called particle physics at the time.
No, no, he didn't believe in any of it. So that's why I didn't interact with him, because I thought it would be pretentious and artificial to cultivate a relationship with Einstein when he didn't believe anything that we were doing, because he didn't believe quantum mechanics, and he didn't think that all these elementary particles were of any importance. He thought they would all be derived someday from a theory of electromagnetism and gravity. So I knew that there wouldn't be any real overlap in our work. And this idea of striking up a friendship or a relationship with this distinguished old man for the sake of historical associations struck me as the kind of thing that people I didn't like did. Today I would feel completely different. Today I wouldn't have those ideas. I would want to know this important, interesting
figure. He died not so long after that.
He died in 55 when I was there on my second visit. And if I remember correctly, the newspaper people were taking pictures of Fuld Hall with the flag at half-staff in connection with reporting his death. And they wanted some human figure in the picture, preferably a pretty young lady. And so my fiancée, Margaret, was the one they asked to pose with her legs crossed in front of the Institute for Advanced Study. So that they could have a human figure in the picture of Fuld Hall with the flag at half staff.
You didn't interact with him on your second visit.
No,
he was probably.
I didn't ever. Well, then he was quite ill.
Yes, yes.
By then he was quite ill. In 51, he wasn't that ill.
Yeah.
I had missed his last seminar. His last seminar was given about a month before I arrived, and everybody was still talking about it. If I had not delayed so long in writing up my dissertation, I would have been there and seen and heard his last seminar at the Institute. He talked, of course, about his attempts to construct a unified theory of gravitation and electromagnetism. It was an entirely unsuitable theory. And, of course, one knows that it should have been a theory including a lot of other particles and a lot of other forces, and it should have been quantum mechanical, and so on and so on. We know that, and we even suspected it then, of course. And the theory just didn't make a lot of sense. It didn't have very sensible interactions between gravity and electromagnetism. But it had nice formal properties, which appealed to Einstein. And by the way, Schrödinger, at just about the same time, came up with just about the same theory, except for using I equals the square root of minus 1, in his equations. In other words, instead of an unsymmetrical metric, he had a complex one, a Hermitian one.
Did you interact with Oppenheimer much?
Oh yes, a great deal. But I was about to say something. Oh, about Einstein's last seminar. What they were talking about was not the content. What they were talking about was that they weren't able to concentrate on the content because of the presentation. He was dressed in the costume that he conventionally wore after his second wife died. And he neglected himself very much after she died. He had on a pair of baggy trousers, unpressed, and shoes with no socks, just to have more time for work, I guess. And a sweatshirt, an old crummy gray sweatshirt. But the particular additional feature when he gave the seminar was that the fly of the trousers was open and the sweatshirt protruded obscenely through the fly. And they were all looking at that and concentrating on that feature, and they were unable to follow what he was saying about the mathematics. I didn't know him, and now, of course, I regret it. It would have been very nice to get to know him in '51.